Hi, we're here with Ryan from Shoreline Roots, the day after they played a tribute to the Legends Festival. How was the festival? Was it what you expected? How was the energy?
Absolutely. Everybody had a wonderful time, the band included. You know, my family came up from L.A. We had such a wonderful time seeing that. You know, I think with having a new venue, everything ran relatively smoothly in comparison to some opinions. So, yeah, I think McKenna put on a great show, and I'm looking forward to tonight's festival as well.
So what are you guys working on in the future? What's for the months to come for Shoreline Roots?
Well, right now, the band and I, we're organizing our next album. You know, we have more than enough material. We just kind of want to choose great songs to come in sequence. And, you know, we got a festival coming up in May. May 12th, we're going to do the Reggae Inland Empire Festival. And we're going to link up with Pato Bantan there, hopefully, for an onstage performance. But in the works, we're looking forward to have Mr. Pato Bantan on our next album. And so like I said, this is all in the works. We're hoping to release an album by summertime.
Tell me about the sound of the new album.
Yeah, so, you know, since the last album, we've kind of revamped the band. We've added members, we've subtracted a couple members, and the result is just an amazing, crucial sound. You know, we have two keyboard players now. We're working with a two horn section, and we're gonna incorporate another girl. So we'll have two female vocalists, two horns, two keyboard players. And, you know, just that combination alone is just unheard of. And so I'm really looking forward to releasing the new sound, you know, with a brand new message pushing consciousness in mankind. And so, you know, we just follow the same song template, but we just offer it with a different style. And Shoreline Roots is pushing the envelope for sure. Yeah.
So where do you go for inspiration?
Well, you know, that's a great question because I feel like inspiration is the type of thing that surrounds you at all times, and sometimes the senses are a little distracted or confused. So when you get that moment of clarity, that's where you find the inspiration. And you kind of notice that the more present you are and remain, the more inspiration that flows. So I kind of see inspiration as that thing that you can pick and choose and sip from at all times, you know.
I like that.
Yeah.
Respect. So Shoreline Roots, you guys have been playing in San Diego for how long?
Well, the band's been together for, I'd say, we're coming up on 2.5 years now. You know, we've been playing since pretty much the first weeks that we got together. We started as a three-piece group, moved into a five-piece group, moved into an eight-piece group, went to a 10 for a couple weeks, went down to an 8, now we're at a 9, and we're pretty solid right now. And I feel like, you know, we're really defining the sound that we're gonna wanna present to the people. You know, and the message is even more clear than it was before. You know, we've had a lot of life experience since that time, and I feel like we've all kind of matured, and people have, you know, advanced and matured in their own individual lives, and so we bring that kind of collective kinetic power together and really just throw it down for that hour or 2 hours that we get on stage, you know. And so, you know, I really love the music that we're making. I love the group that we find together, you know, and it's always there. We have a great group of people working together, and so we always just expect the best from ourselves, really.
So where do you think the future of reggae music is going? Where is it headed?
I see reggae going back to where it was truly very popular when it first pushed the first envelope, you know, through the Wailer styles and through styles of the Gladiators and just that old, you know, real group sound, 10 members, 8 members, horn sections, and vocalists, and I can see it going back there, you know, with the same song and new message kind of type thing. You know, I can see in the community, I see the community growing. I see a lot of dreadlocks at a lot of the shows that I go to, a lot of familiar faces. You know, I know people are truly holding the faith, and I could just see that that's where the music, in my opinion, is. That's where it's going right now, you know, with a little bit of synth, obviously. Push the envelope on the synth sounds, and it's really coming together, you know, to a true perfection. I can feel it. Yeah.
Leucadia, you do like a reggae night there.
Yeah, we have a pickup group at the Bar Leucadian, Leucadia, California, and that's basically, it's just a five-piece, and we kind of play all the standards and just kind of freestyle, try out new songs there, and just kind of, you know, progress our styles and our chops and stuff like that. We also offer the stage up to know other bands or musicians looking for the same kind of quality time there. You know, I personally have grown as a singer, and I play drums there occasionally and a little bass, and so everybody just kind of gets their style down a little bit better. You know, we work on breaks, like rhythms and drum and bass lines, and you know, just trying to dub out the vocals here and there. So yeah, it's a wonderful function. It's a free time, 8 to 11 at the Bar Leucadian, and catch us there every Monday.
Awesome. All right, we're here with Ryan from Shoreline Roots.
Big love and respect, RollinSD. I want to thank you all for having me here, keeping the reggae scene alive, keeping the vibe true, keeping these interviews to the people, you know, because we all want to know what's going on, and we all like to hear it from the mouths that it comes from. So big love and respect, and keep the vibes alive. Best love.
Respects. Thanks, man.